mountain upwards, right to the top.
Make Me a Musical is what I like to think of as a light-hearted romp that takes an affectionate dig at a lot of the classic musicals, like West Side Story, My Fair Lady, A Chorus Line, Singing in the Rain, Damn Yankees, and a number of others, all wrapped up in a story of love and intrigue, loosely, very loosely, based on the legend of Faust and his pact with the devil. The show starts off with a parody of West Side Story, where a gang of street toughs do a dance reminiscent of the choreography for When You're a Jet. Except in this instance, the gang is not out for a rumble. They're simply warming up for an audition for a new Broadway show.
Let's keep it moving, let's keep it moving. Onwards and upwards, right to the top.
Inside the theatre where the auditions are being held, auditioners are lined up and grilled, just as in a chorus line, where they have to tell something revealing about themselves, except that here, the kind of sob stories that worked in a chorus line are written off as dramatic clichés. The producer here is looking for something different. Innocence, perhaps, a very rare quality these days. One of those auditioning is an ingenue named Angela, who, in a spoof of Hello Dolly, describes herself as an ordinary girl. But as the lyrics of her song soon reveal, she is anything but ordinary. The song is sung here by the wonderful Claire Moore, who has graced the London and Broadway stages in leading roles in shows such as Phantom of the Opera and Miss Saigon.
I'm just an ordinary girl. There's nothing much to say about me. I'm just an ordinary girl in almost every way. So you see, there's very little I've got to tell you. I really don't have much soap to sell you. I come from an average family. I'm as ordinary as a girl can be. I'm just a very, very ordinary girl. I am the daughter of an ordinary millionaire from an ordinary mansion uptown Bel Air. It's a mansion that was once owned by Fred Astaire, and we had a musical wing where I learned how to sing. We had an ordinary home with a marble hall. I recall there were Van Goghs and Vermeers hanging on the wall, and that's all. There was a butler, a maid, a chauffeur, a lot of antiques and a Chippendale sofa.
The company then go into a chorus line dance routine to a number called Reaching the Top, which is sung here by Kathryn-Evans, another star of many London productions in Evita and Sunset Boulevard, among others.
Let's keep it moving, let's keep it moving. Onwards and upwards, right to the top.
Come on, let's go, let's get the show up and running.
Let's keep it moving, right to the top.
Let's try to give it everything that we got.
Give it all you got, give it your best shot.
Gotta keep our engines going.
Make it go up.
Gotta keep the temperature hot.
Make the show up.
We want a show that's simply stunning. If we really want to keep it running, then we gotta give it all that we got.
Let's keep it moving, let's keep it moving. Onwards and upwards, right to the top.
The rehearsal pianist is named Robert Ponsonby, and he, as you'd expect in a musical, has secret ambitions, or not so secret ambitions, to become a writer of Broadway songs. But he feels he's been hampered in his ambitions by the fact that he was born a white Anglo-Saxon Protestant with the unfortunate name of Robert Ponsonby. He feels that he would have a much greater chance of success if he had been born foreign or black or gay. "I've tried being gay," he says, "but I just can't seem to get the hang of it."
If you were born a white Anglo-Saxon male, some people think that you are beyond the pale. They think that ethnic color is what I lack. They just think I'm a hack. There's no doubt about it, a WASP isn't quite the right thing to be. Even if you got what it takes, you won't get the breaks if you should lack some street credibility. Nobody takes me seriously at all. Nobody wants to hear what I've got to say. They all just think my background is far too gray. No one thinks I'm okay.
Robert plays one of his songs to Angela, and of course they end up in a duet.
There came a moment, one magic moment. It was the first time that I saw you. In that brief moment, I knew I loved you, and now I feel you all around, in every sight, in every sound.
Naturally, Angela and Robert fall in love with all the innocent passion of Judy Garland and Mickey Rooney in one of their early Let's Do the Show Right Here musicals. Is there anyone still alive who can remember the days of such innocence? Robert is walking on cloud nine after his first date with Angela. And in a scene reminiscent of the Singing in the Rain dance sequence with Gene Kelly and the Dustmans and the rain pouring down, Robert tries to follow in Gene Kelly's footsteps as he dances and sings about falling in love. Robert even continues to sing while being mugged by two hoodlums. In the incongruous world of the musical, of course, nothing interrupts a song.
It's only 8 from now. I don't hear sleigh bells ringing. And yet somehow it feels like Christmas, and I can't help singing. What the heck's come over me today? Why this crazy urge to sing? Why should I be feeling that it's Christmas every day when it's only spring? It's her I'm thinking of. Could this be the start of love? I have never, ever been in love before, so how can I be sure? I only know when she is there, life seems quiet without a care. Maybe she's the one that I've been waiting for. Why do I feel